I Just, can we wait for one more family?
Please stand and turn this way for the lighting of the Easter candle. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to Christ and all ages. To Christ be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. By his holy and gracious wounds, may Christ our Lord guard us and keep us.
Amen.
May the light of Christ, rising in glory, vanquish darkness in our hearts and minds.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And saying together, Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we, who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection, may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
The first lesson from the Old Testament is from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. At that time, says the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. When Israel sought for rest, the Lord appeared to him from far away. I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, I have continued my faithfulness to you. Again, I will build you, and you shall be built, O Virgin Israel. Again, you shall take your tambourines and go forth in the dance of the merrymakers. Again, you shall plant vineyards on the mountains of Samaria. The planter shall plant and enjoy the fruit. For there shall be a day when the sentinels will call in the hill country of Ephraim, come, let us go up to Zion, to the house of our Lord our God. Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Thanks be to God.
From the book of Colossians. If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth, for you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed,
then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be always acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Easter is a shared event. In this day of great individualization, it's worth saying that Easter is a shared event. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the other Mary, went together to grieve. They were going to do the rites of burial to the rock at the end of the road, and they found the rock rolled away, where they expected darkness, light, the tomb empty, the future open. On the road to Emmaus, two disciples were saying a blessing over a meal, lifting and breaking the bread, and Christ was present. Doubting Thomas, behind closed doors at evening prayer with his fellow disciples, found the risen Christ, sharing his wounds. Christ fulfills Jeremiah's prophecy, "I will be the God of the families of Israel." Christ fulfilled what Jesus lived. Blessed are you poor, blessed are you who mourn, you who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for yours shall be, yours is, the kingdom of God. Easter is a new exodus, the Passover meal, opened to all. Take, eat, do this in remembrance of me. It's idolatrous to make of Jesus a singular and isolated hero. Unique and special? Yes. Sent from God? Yes. Embodying God in a special way? Yes. But not a superhero like Zeus or Athena or a Western cowboy or cowgirl riding alone across the plain. From Palm Sunday through Passover supper through the meeting with the governor on Good Friday, Jesus engaged his people's central events, even crying out, my God, why have you forsaken me? Jesus is calling to what he knew as Abba, our Father. Christ is born of creation and God's history. God in Christ opens our history afresh. Now the future determines our life more than the past. What's most wonderful is less that God once created the world than is still creating the world through all his suffering servants. The Creator absorbs our wounds and opens a new future. Now, forgive me if what I'm about to say is old hat for you. It's new to me. The Oregon forest participates in death and resurrection. The Oregon forest participates in Easter. Our neighboring Lutheran pastor introduced me to a grove of trees near Monroe, 20 miles from here. Oregon and Washington scientists have studied the groves. The trees thrive together. They do fine when transplanted together. They die when transplanted alone. A singular tree, ball and stem, even when well watered, will die alone. The trees need shared roots. They need shared fungi in the soil. Fungi, their roots pass back and forth. The fungi is their Holy Spirit. The chemicals in the roots are the same as the chemicals in our neurotransmitters. The carbon in the stars is the same as the carbon in Christ's blood. Easter is happening above and below and around us. I'm happy to go for walks in the forest and peer into the night sky, especially when I'm away from ambient light and can really see the full night sky. And know that I'm connected to the cosmos. However, that's not enough to ground me or lead me home. It's little comfort in a crisis to hear that I share chemicals with fungi or even elements with the stars. When I'm alone or abandoned, injured or dying, who is close by? To whom do I belong? When I seek a new order, overcoming injustice and oppression, with whom do I share my sufferings, my yearnings, my strivings? Who leads me? Easter rolls away the rock at the end of the road. Easter opens the future
In cross and resurrection, God in Christ reaches as far as possible to give us a shared life, yes, with nature and even more with human nature. We can fly now into interstellar space, but we're still learning to walk on the earth like human beings, our island home. I'm learning the root system of Good Samaritan, if you will, in housing and healthcare. Art and music are how our tendrils go forth to Corvallis and to Oregon and beyond. We'll soon in our service be invited to turn to a neighbor and say, Shalom, the peace of God be with you. We are invited to be an Easter people and pray, give all of us this day our daily bread. Hallowed be your name. Let us stand and affirm our faith in our baptismal covenant, which holds our first creed. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated on the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will pass out.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and when you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? In the power of the resurrection, let us pray, be with us and guide us.
For the whole bright earth, lovingly created and compassionately redeemed, that it may reveal the glory of God, let us pray to our Creator.
Be with us and guide us.
For all nations and peoples of the earth, that all may be transformed by mercy to live together in hope.
Be with us and guide us.
For the Holy Church, whose life is hid with Christ in God, that in all our diversity we may witness to one Spirit.
Be with us, God.
For all in high places of authority, for whom Christ was put to death and raised, that they may be led to govern with equity and justice, bringing life to those in the shadow of death, let us pray to our Redeemer.
Be with us, God, O God.
For all captives, prisoners, and those with whom the Holy One shares suffering and abandonment, that they may find strength, freedom, and forgiveness.
Be with us, God, O God.
For all who suffer in mind, body, or soul, for whom Christ is risen with healing in his wings, that we may be comforted. Let us pray to our healer.
Be with us and guide us, O God.
For all who have died and all who grieve, that in Christ we may find light perpetual and blessed assurance.
Be with us and guide us, O God.
For all gathered in this assembly, that we, like Mary and Peter and John, may see the tomb empty and walk in newness of life, let us pray to the risen Christ.
be with us in righteousness, O
God. Rejoicing in the risen presence of our Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, and ourselves to Christ, to whom we give laud and praise, now and forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
God's peace. God's peace be with you. We invite all who are young in spirit at any age. Remember, the saints grow younger every year, to come forward and add a flower to the cross.
Come on, children. Come on up, children.
Parents may come too.
been a long winter.
Bring offerings, give thanks, and come into the Lord's courts with praise.
Thank you.
give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is God.
Christ is risen. Christ is alive.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Hallelujah, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God, for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Please stand. Let us pray. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and the cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another. You have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world, and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. And may the blessing of God our Creator, Christ our brother born of our sister Mary, and the Holy Spirit who lives and moves through all things be with you now and always.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.